out from the hood, nigga, I will bag you. Back three, back three, back four.
Yes, man, it really is me. Me is Zool, aka the Instant Burner, man. And y'all already know, if y'all have played 2K, you already know the defense in this game is fucking trash, man. And it's no fixing it, man. But today, I'm going to give y'all the best settings to try to stop, man, all this cheese, all these blow-by animations, all that, man. I'm going to show you how to fix that, man. But before we get started, y'all know, make sure to smash that like. Make sure to subscribe for more great content, man. Especially if you're somebody that needs help in 2K. I'm the guy that you should be coming to. But let's go ahead and get into it, man. You want to go to your options. You want to go to your controller. Very first thing, bro, this is not a thing that you have to do, but this is one of them things that I like to do. When it comes to vibration, I turn this shit off. I turn this shit off for offensive purposes and for defense. If y'all want me to go over the best offensive settings, like your pro stick and all that, comment offense in the comments below and I will make a video on that. But y'all like to turn this off because it just makes everything better, bro. The vibration in this game is so inconsistent, bro, that it's really not worth it. So I turn vibration off all the time. I turn off my speaker, I turn this off. But like I said, that is a personal preference. Like I said, pro stick orientation, that's part of the offensive side. Off-ball freelance mode. If you don't know what this means, this pretty much means when your guy does not have the ball, how do you want to move around the court? Do you want to have it on camera relative or do you want to have it on absolute? If you don't know what absolute is, absolute means up is up, left is left, right is right, down is down, anywhere on the court. You know what I'm saying? With this one, man, what I've realized, I keep this on camera relative because it makes it easier when you're moving around the court. So, because, man, you don't want to have up being up, left being left. It just makes everything confusing, bro. It makes you like a stick character. So you want to have off-ball camera relative on camera. I mean, you want to have off-ball freelance mode on camera relative. I can't talk. The next thing, man, let's see what else we have on defense, man. Pro stick defense. With this one right here, pro stick defense is when you're pro stick defense is pretty much right stick defense. That's what that means. That means if you're trying to put your hand up, if you're trying to face guard the player, you know what I'm saying? How do you want this to be? Do you want this to be camera relative or do you want it to be absolute? With this one right here, you want this one to be absolute. The reason is, if you want to put your hands up, you want your hands button to be up on the right stick. You don't want it to be camera relative where it might be left, it might be right, it might be diagonal left. It's easier just to put this right here on absolute. And if you want to face guard, you can face guard with the left or the right hand. Makes it way easier just to have this right here on absolute. Intense D. I know a lot of people that turn this off. The reason I would keep this on right here, I would keep Intense D on, is because, man, when these dudes come in the park, bro, and they do this bullshit, the step backs, we've all seen the step backs, the killer step backs where you can't stop it. If your player is close enough within like an arm's distance, he will automatically contest that shot by itself if he goes up, which will make that shot lightly contested. If it depends on how far you are from your defender. I mean, from the offensive player, I can't talk. From the offensive player, so this will make it a lightly contested or a heavily contested, however far that he hits the step back when it comes to separation. So you want to always have this shot reaction in Intense D on, unless you're a center and you're playing twos. If you're playing twos, you already know, if you play twos, man, you need to be able to crash the rebound if you're a center. If you're a center playing twos, you want to have this on off. You know what I'm saying? Because you don't want to be contesting when somebody comes off a screen when you should be running back to get to grab that rebound. You know what I'm saying? So if you're playing twos or anything like that, you want to have this Intense D off. But if you're the guard, you need to already have it on. But if you're playing threes and you're a center, bro, you need to go ahead and have this on because your guards can still get that rebound. You know what I'm saying? And most of y'all hedge, or at least I like to hedge. I don't like to do too much switching or anything like that. And if somebody comes off that screen, you can still get a good contest. So if you're playing threes and you're a center, have this on. And if you're a guard, I always have this on guard. On. I can't talk today. When it comes to who to guard, it's way, way different than 2K17. In 2K17, you wanted this off at all times. You wanted it off on all times just because the switching defense in 2K17 was way worse. I will give 2K credit when it comes to switching this year. It is way, way better. So this is pretty much like a preference. I would keep this on. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't have a gravitational force like 2K17 did, so you can keep it on and still be able to switch cleanly. So I would keep this on just so you know who to guard, especially if you're somebody running with randoms, because randoms, bro, they don't like to pick up the closest man next to them. They like to depend on the arrow, you know what I'm saying? So they might run to where the arrow tells them to go because they're so dependent. So if you can, try to keep this on, bro. It doesn't make a big difference this year like 2K17 is what I'm trying to say. And this is a big one right here, defensive assist. Like I told y'all, I play a lot of center this year, and I played some, and I played guard this year, so I've mess with this a lot. I would always, if you have this on zero, I would always have this on something, just because, man, what the defensive assist is, it pretty much helps you stop that first move. So if somebody likes to do like a rhythm dribble speed boost, it'll help you slide in that direction to cut him off. What this needs to be on depends on how fast your player is. If you have a fast player like me, I have a play sharp speed like a 90, so you know what I'm saying, my sliding speed is very fast. Since my sliding speed is very fast, I can cut off people pretty fast. So I like to put this right here on around 60 to 70. Right now I have mine on 70. If you're a slower player like a pure sharp, like a center or anything like this, this should be no higher than 30. No higher than 30, because if you have this too high and you're like a pure sharp with a slow sliding speed, you're going to be too sluggish. You're not going to be able to move around the court, but you need it on something. So 30 is what you need on if you're a center or anything like that, or a slow sliding player. Excuse me. When it comes to box out strength, a lot of y'all sleep on the box out strength. If you are a guard, this should be on 100. It should be on 100, nothing less. Because what y'all sleep on, when a shot goes up, with this being on, without you even having to press L2, he'll automatically twist around and box out the player without you doing anything, since the box out assist is already on. If you're a center, this needs to be no lower than 80. No lower than 80. Me personally, I would keep it on 100. I've tried this on 50, 60, 70, and I've seen 80 to 100 is the best if you're a center. I would still keep it on 100 just because it will help you box out. So you want to keep this on as high as you can, as high as you can tolerate. You can flick it around, see what works best for you, but you want to have this as high as it can go. But if y'all want me, like I said, if y'all want me to show y'all the best offensive settings on this game, like I said, comment offense. Don't forget to check out other great videos from yours truly, man, by clicking on that left box or the right box. And y'all already know who this is. It is your boy, Mizzle.